dealing with resentments. Hi, my name is Jenith and I'm an addictions counselor in the Winnipeg area. I have decided to do a series of videos to help people understand more completely the dynamics of the disease of addiction. I'm going to address how addictions commonly develop and will also focus on some practices that can be used to overcome addiction. Anytime I refer to a substance or drug of choice, please feel free to substitute food, gambling, sex, shopping, or any other habitual coping behaviors. Today, we are going to look at the detrimental effects of carrying resentments. Resentment is perhaps the emotion that is most significant in addiction and recovery. Resentments are negative feelings that you can't let go of and that you replay in your mind often. We feel resentment when we think we've been wronged by someone, and those feelings of anger, sadness, and disappointment don't go away. Most, if not all, addicts feel resentment towards someone. Those persistent negative feelings can drive a person to use drugs or alcohol as a means of escaping and feeling better. When a person quits using drugs or alcohol, their feelings of resentment will be high, and they may even have new resentments. Recovery should feel good, but resentments are big hurdles to cross. Resentment is also an emotion that can have the longest lasting negative impact on a relationship, and it is impossible to repair a broken relationship without both partners addressing their resentment towards each other. Addiction can cause particularly poignant feelings of resentment within relationships and within families. The families of addicts may feel resentment towards the addict for causing them to have so many bad experiences and emotions. In addition to any prior resentments, addicts in recovery often develop feelings of resentment toward family members, like if they think their family is too distrustful of them. Resentments are addictive feelings and they are toxic. In order to overcome resentments, we need to acknowledge exactly what they are. Writing down your feelings can really help. You must realize that resentments serve you no purpose but to hurt you and hold you back, and feeling resentment does nothing but allow the person who hurt you to continue interfering with your life. Counseling can help a lot. There are so many emotions that come back in early recovery for both addicts and their families. If they aren't dealt with, feelings of anger, sadness, and disappointment can turn into hate and other destructive thoughts and feelings. You must learn to let go of your resentments, not for the person who hurt you, but for yourself. Here are some steps towards letting go of resentments. Number one, describe the resentment you are experiencing, both in fact and in feeling. Number two, approach the resentment as a choice. You have a choice to hold on to it or to let go of it. Number three, become willing to live without the resentment. Number four, acknowledge your part in the situation, if that's applicable. Forgive yourself for that and decide not to let it happen again. Number five, forgive when you can and practice deliberate forgetting when you cannot. Keep in mind that these acts of forgiveness are gifts to yourself rather than capitulation to those who you resent. Six, practice gratitude for what you have. And seven, don't forget to be kind to yourself. Holding on to a resentment is like drinking a poison and expecting the other person to die. In order to recover, we must let go. I hope this has been useful. Welcome to the Addictions Cafe. Help is out there and recovery is possible.